Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Swiss Dota 2 Championships, the semi-finals, match 2, round 2, and this game with the Hornik Mena versus Rhino Gaming. I am Morality Claws, and I am joined today by my co-caster, Zach Owen. How are you doing?
How's it going? Not in the game.
You're not in the game?
No. I got my Dota crashed.
Can you reconnect?
No.
You cannot reconnect. Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding you, no.
Alright, hang on a sec.
Maybe you ask for rehost, like, go to an all pick afterwards, after they've drafted.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll mute myself until then.
No, wait.
Oh.
You know what? You can go watch my broadcast, actually.
Oh, just into the cast.
Just go into the broadcast and I'll go contact my superiors. All right then. Can you see my broadcast?
Second. Are they on the second medium pick right now?
They are on the second pick and ban, yes. Second pick, yeah. Okay. Second, both. Queen of Pain, Bristleback, Gyrocopter, the line, yep.
I'm behind.
What are you on?
Do I go to watch? Right. Where do I go to see it live?
Radiant. You click on the live button, or maybe Steam broadcasts with Dota 2 actually puts in a 2-minute delay.
Oh yeah. Maybe just ask for like an all pick afterwards and we can get
Yeah,
it.
Fine, I'll try and solo cast this then. 10 seconds to go. Not good. Alright then. 5 seconds. Nothing much coming out till now. There's been a Queen of Pain. Actually, you can tag along and see what kind of decisions you...
Reserve tag. Sort of, ah, yeah. Okay.
Alright, so...
I think Dying and Leshrac's been banned.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's pretty standard bans, and Dying has been very strong these last few... last few months, you could say. Leshrac as well, I mean, both of them combined are horrible. I mean, the slow does work well. Tombstone and Decay, all that really works well together with Leshrac.
Yeah, that's a good point, that is.
There's been a Queen of Pain and a Bristleback being picked up by the Hornik Mena. You hate Queen of Pain?
I hate Queen of Pain, yeah, and it's been picked up here. Yeah, they prioritised the Silencer and Earthshaker over the Queen of Pain and Bristleback ban. 5 seconds. And then that just leaves the Dire, just wanted to pick that up.
I mean, the Queen of Pain is of course very strong, the Bristleback as well can be very strong, especially versus a Gyrocopter that we have here. Showing the back to the Gyrocopter means...
Yeah, that, I understand what you mean.
Just both leave lobby. And join as spectators. We could do that, yeah.
Could do it from 2 minutes behind, yeah.
It's unfortunate for everyone watching the stream.
They're already behind a little bit anyway.
I guess. Alright people, we'll be discussing about the same bands anyway. I will disconnect from the lobby. And rejoin quickly. Hang on.
Yeah. Sorry about this, my Dota just crashed. And I was loading in as well. I was wondering what happened. It's banned. Are you on 4th Radiant ban? Reserve time. There we go then. Let's continue casting.
Yep. 10 seconds. I believe that solves that problem.
Yeah,
yeah, I already saw this. So they picked up a Lina. Gyrocopter, Lina, Lion, Lina. Some pretty nasty stuff there. Especially the Lion, Lina. Secure stun into a not so secure stun. But that can be secured with the Gyrocopter Lina combination Wombination.
Yeah, and the Hex as well. Gets rid of the Bristleback passive as one of the Queen of Pain's slipperiness.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I so want Rhino to win against Queen of Pain.
Now, keep your bias out of here.
Okay.
Yeah, anything? You're seeing anything strange here?
Strange. Lion. Very strange. Not picked a lot in competitive. Like,
I would argue there that it's kind of an on and off pick.
Yeah, I guess so. And these players here are all, like, clued up about the game and stuff. So, Lion must be... So, well, I think Lion's a hero that the Rhino Gaming are familiar with, probably.
Mm-hmm. Good point, yeah.
So there's no harm in picking it up. And there's a few respects coming out from the Dire, as well as that Wind Ranger and that Phoenix.
That
oh wait,
is
the Phoenix.
True.
Phoenix was played by LC last game.
Disruptor being picked. Now, the Disruptor, I would have expected him to be picked up by Rhino Gaming. Maybe this is more of a block pick.
It could be, if Lina went mid. I could agree with you there.
This is going to be interesting because I really like watching Disruptors, but he just doesn't see enough play because he's very niche as well.
Niche is the right word.
Mm-hmm.
Reserve time. I want to really like. I want to see what they do with the lanes, the Radiant. I want to see if they do an aggro tri lane. Like, that could be really good if they do an aggro tri lane.
Aggro tri lane on the Radiant.
Yeah, that could be really good, especially against Disruptor. Disruptor melts.
Yeah, considering though, they might. That is a good point. Disruptor does melt away in an aggressive tri lane, but they don't want to put the Gyrocopter on the aggressive tri lane.
I think Gyro does find farm on an aggressive tri lane, and especially with Lion and Lina, there's the potential to go really aggressive. And if the other team go really aggressive, they just like, yo, hold up, we can kick you up. They can probably kick some ass.
True that. They pick up a Tidehunter, so I don't think they're going to go aggressive.
No, I don't think they will either. Well, would Tidehunter fare better against the offlane Bristleback if Tidehunter went safe lane?
To be honest, it's kind of even, I believe. He's got Anchor Smash, which means Bristleback can't last hit, but Bristleback will probably be last hitting with Bristles anyway. Abaddon.
That's a good defensive player, just to stop all the nuke damage from Gyro Lion and Lina.
Good point. Huh. Slark is banned out on Rhino's side as well. Yeah.
They did put up that slot ban last game. It's one of the players on the phone with a Slark. Like, do you know?
There's one of the players on Hornig Meta play Slark. I'm not sure. I don't think so. I think it's just because Slark is a very good pick these days.
Drow would be very good for Rhino Gaming, actually. That extra bounce time for Lina, Lion, and Gyro.
I believe you're lagging out a bit there, mate.
Lagging a bit right now?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
No, don't worry. Maybe it's on my end.
And the last pick, what do you think the last pick's going to be? They're going to need a mid. I reckon Storm Spirit.
They're going to either need a mid or an offlane. I'm going to guess mid is Storm Spirit here. No, they don't need an offlane.
Yes.
They need a mid or a... No, they actually go for another support, so that means Lina's going to go mid.
Okay, then. Two sisters, Lina and Crystal Maiden.
On the same team.
Same team, yeah. Best friends.
Not really.
Not really, no. They're really... Like, let's kill potential of the Lion and the Crystal Maiden. That's like a mid. You know,
oh yeah, oh yeah.
15 minute Aghanim Scepter, and that would be fun.
That could actually be a better possibility. Give the Lion mid, maybe, but you know, it's both Lina and Lion can go mid. They're equally strong mid.
Got a bit of well, and I haven't listened yet.
Okay, hang on a sec. You really are lagging out. Hang on. You've only got a 0.02%. Oh dear, that's a huge packet loss.
Is that me or you?
Oh no, now you got it. Now you got it. There you go.
There.
Alright, your lag has stopped. Anyway, what do you think the Hornet Men will pick up for their last pick?
They need a carry.
And there you go. So this is going to be a pretty interesting match.
Way too many boobs in this game.
Are you kidding me? My Dota just failed as well. Oh no. Yes, it was in fact my Dota that failed then. Oh my god, really?
I think something's wrong with Dota.
Oh yeah.
I haven't seen Luna played much. Actually, we did see last week, we saw the Luna against the Undying and it
kind of fell apart in the Luna.
Yeah.
Considering she's one of the squishiest heroes level 1.
I think she is, apart from... No, I think Luna is the squishiest, right?
No, Kothel maybe?
I'll keep her the shite, yeah, that's a good point.
Alright, hang on. Alright, let us watch a game. And switch back to the recording, actually, hang on a sec. And there. Alright.
There's one problem with spectating.
What?
Oh, there we go, I can do free camera. There we go. Oh, I was scared then.
That you could only have directed cam? Yeah, that wouldn't be too good, would it?
No, it wouldn't, no. So, on the side of Rhino Gaming, we have Hacksaw playing the Crystal Maiden.
Hang on a sec. Hang on a sec.
Hang on.
I'm not actually in yet.
Oh, alright then.
Alright, there we go, there we go. Alright, free camera.
Okay. Hacksaw on the Crystal Maiden. We have Wolverine on the Gyrocopter. We have Don't You Know I'm Loco, I think, going on that mid laner. We have Fimo going on that line, and Arkosh on a solo offlane Tidehunter.
And quick thing, because I see there's going to be an engagement soon. We have Fail on the Queen of Pain, LC on the Disruptor, Residuum Tats on the Luna, Curl of Light on the Bristleback, and last but not least, Edo isn't on the Abaddon. And they're going to start a chase here. Oh, good stun, getting Abaddon, but unfortunately, they're going to still chase here. Well, this is a very slow chase. Well, that was disappointing, to say the least.
Where's Dire Courier?
Oh yeah, they don't have a courier. What the heck? What?
LC has no money. Edoism has a little bit of money.
I feel like someone
communication.
Yeah, miscommunicated there. I did like the set on that Queen of Pain though.
Ooh.
Simple, but effective.
Yeah, the Abaddon set's quite nice.
Oh, Fimo and Hacksaw going in for a smoke gank already. They will in fact see LC, who's probably going to end up very dead here. Or not. Yes, he will.
First blood to Loco.
First blood to Loco. Good rotations there.
Yeah, and it's a great start for Rhino Gaming.
Great start indeed.
Yeah, where did the bounty runes go?
Queen of Pain. Yeah.
Gentleman's agreement.
So anyway, there seems to be some kind of roaming strike going on here between the Lying and the CM. Leaving Wolverine alone to solo farm against this offlane Bristleback and Edoism.
I think Wolverine can find the farm, and I think they're just going to have to agree that both people will get CS. Wolverine has been leveling the Homing Missile, and Lina's got another kill.
Just close, very close. In fact, Shadow Strike is not leveled enough, she'll just out-tango the damage.
Yeah, that was close. Oh wait, the range creep.
No, it's not going to kill her. In fact, Lion pauses the game first.
We have a pause coming out here.
Lag, moment, lags. Alright then. Let's hope we're not being DDoSed. I think we aren't.
Yeah, hopefully not.
Benny, du stinkst nach Fisch. Alright.
What does that mean?
Alright, right, first one means shout out to Benny, you smell like fish. The second one says, Lukey's hamster needs a breather. The next thing, and I bet someone's trying to say Edu, meaning the Obi basics, it says Edu, my love.
Okay.
Yes.
Then some juicy banter.
We are a weird bunch, we Swiss Dota folk.
Oh yeah. And it's 1-0 to Rhino Gaming, if anybody was wondering.
It actually, yeah, there you go. Yeah. So, will we see another engagement here on the bot rune? Loco is gonna... Ooh, nice! Nice jump there from Queen of Pain. Let's see, what will Loco do? Ooh! That could be very bad for the Queen of Pain. She activated the regen rune already. Elsie's there to help, though, and there you go. Dead Loco.
Yeah, it's quite unfortunate for Loco there. He's had a really good start in the mid lane. He's 2 kills up, but fail getting one back.
And we are actually gonna throw up Blast Hits and Denies here. Luna doing pretty well for herself, a solo on the top lane. It's against a Tidehunter. It's really...
Yeah,
just...
Tide...
Although Tide has 13 hits.
Tide can shut out Luna quite well, actually. That Kraken Shell as well. Basically, no damage to Tide.
Something seems up with Residuans. He's making a few mistakes there.
He has a salve anyway, so that should be fine. And on the bot lane, bit of aggression being shown by Wolverine. Oh, Cola Light going in. And here we go again. Cola Light played the Witch Doctor last game, now he's playing the Bristleback. Just shows the
versatile
dexterity. Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, like, Luna's range is basically melee. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good point, yeah. Arkosh has the smash as well.
Hex is up, but nothing will come out of it. Yes, melee until you get glaives, and that's when you really can start to shine. Queen of Pain killing Loco again on the mid lane. Missed that. Seems like these engagements are pretty interesting from both of them. And apparently someone did buy a courier.
Oh, it took some time though, didn't it?
Did really did. It's quite interesting. Yeah. Why is the courier... It's not even flying yet.
It's only 4 minutes in, so...
Something seems up with this team.
You're gonna buy the courier? No, I'm gonna buy some clarities. No. Right, no. Arkosh on the top lane.
Arkosh going crazy. Yeah. What is this Edoans that's doing? Can someone tell me that? It's like he's playing a completely different person. It's like someone replaced his body. Bristleback does die on the bot lane.
Oh, yeah. Wolverine playing really good on the gyrocopter yet again. Oh, Arkosh is in trouble. Oh, he's got a salve. He should be fine.
I'm seriously wondering, though. It's like someone replaced Residuans. That's someone else.
Yeah, he's playing really aggressive and quite ballsy. Bit silly to an extent.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Yeah, cool Cola Light going in a war raid, but nice stun from Fimo. In fact, that could be a dead Cola Light here. Shield will probably... He needs to hit the shield before the shield runs out. There you go.
I think it's only level 1. It's a level 2 homing missile.
It's leveling homing missile. Yes, homing missile over Fleck. God damn it.
Package has been used on the top lane, so that's a cooldown for 150 seconds now.
But it does secure a kill, which is pretty nice. Ah yes, the really good old trash talking in the Twitch chat has already begun.
Hope you die in hell, Edu, Penny. Shout out to Hyperactivity for being very hyper. Very aggressive.
I think that's the guy. I think that's the guy they called Benny in the chat earlier.
I think it is.
Rotations to bot lane for fail. Probably going to pick up this rune here. Depending on what it is. Depending, it's a bounty rune. Only standard bounty rune. Regen will be picked up by Loco. So he's actually going to fail. He's actually going to start something on the bot lane here.
Dire's mid tower.
Let's have a look what's going to happen. Will Fail jump in? Meanwhile, on the top lane, it looks like there's also going to be an engagement for now. Let's watch this bot lane. Color Light's coming in. Sonic Wave can be used to secure. She will not, however, secure. Color Light will die. Edwism will probably be the next one. No, he shields up last second, but dies anyway. Meanwhile, top lane, Tidehunter did get a kill on Luna. And now Fail is the one running. Running away.
Don't you know Loco ulted the creep?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought he ulted the,
The other one. They both died, he just ulted the creep. He's meant to ult the Queen of Pain, because the creep was literally just on top, and I was like, oh, it's a dead Queen of Pain, but he ults the creep.
Yeah. It's pretty interesting there.
One's outlast it, that's all. I was now, here's Axel, living life on the edge.
Just having, you know, staying on the top there. Trying to protect the Arkosh, I'm going to say. Oh, they're taking a stack, actually. That's not, Luna's not going to like that. In fact, Luna's going to go right in there. That Blinks was not worth it, though. And here you go. Will Haxel end up dead here? Yes, he will.
Yeah, Haxel dies there.
And Arkosh Tower will continue taking the stack on the back lines.
Yeah, Arkosh couldn't give a shit. He's just like, I'm having my farm, mate.
I'm having a good old giggle, mate.
Oh, Ravage is up in 5 seconds.
Will it be used, though, is the question. Will he use Ravage?
Both of them, I reckon he'll go for it.
If he goes, he can use Ravage solely on Residuin's ads. Yeah, he can probably get a kill here. Meanwhile, Lina killing the Bristleback, Arkosh gets a kill on Tino. This Arkosh is having the time of his life.
Yeah, look at the fight recap. He just got 400 gold for absolutely nothing apart from a Ravage and early on, and LC's going down. Ooh.
Ooh, here we go. Here we go. Nice kill from the Queen of Pain on the Tidehunter. Now Haxel will be the next one to come, but Loco's there, invisible, and will actually get a kill on the Fail.
Ooh. 500 gold for Queen, for Lina. There we go. Reckon Lina goes Yule Scepter now?
Probably. Just to make sure she can have the secured stuns.
Yeah, when did Luna use Eclipse?
When did Luna use the Eclipse? What do you mean?
Eclipse.
Clips. I was like, Clips. Like, was she machine gunning people? I'm not sure, actually.
Sander's being very mean.
That's funny.
I can see the future of this match.
That's funny, Sander. That's really funny. Yes.
Yeah, funny.
I'll see me while taking a fall here.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
That's so funny, Sander. You're the most hilarious person on this planet, you know that.
It isn't my fault, okay?
Oh my god.
I'm sorry for our 30 viewers.
You guys, please stick around. We're so much better.
We will prevail. See, you don't get this English banter on a German stream, do you?
No, because it's all in German over there.
It's all in German, exactly, so stay here. There's more to come. And Arkosh dies on the top lane to Luna. The Eclipse was used there.
Oh, that
That's
was
a cooldown.
Oh, then Residuin's out. Let's see if he's going to play less silly from now on.
Yeah, I think he's just going to be very passive on the top lane now, and he's getting some levels in Glaives, and he's not really prioritising that Luna Blessing. He has the max Lucent Beam here.
Oh, that's obvious. I mean, you want the nuke damage before it falls off.
Oh, yeah. So, what do you think you go on the Luna? Okay, he's gone for Morbid Mask.
Yeah, he's going the Hotted. He's going the Hotted.
I reckon you can go Mask of Madness Luna, because that's what something I like to do.
It's an interesting build, but it makes you so squishy.
Oh, yeah, but you just spend all of your time farming. It's just amazing. I do recommend it.
Yes, follow the recommendations.
Yeah, follow
Loco will in fact be start looking for Luna. This ward here. I can't draw on the ground anymore. Great.
Oh, that's horrible. And Arkosh. Oh, Haxel getting a kill bot lane, I think. No, he was mid. Sorry.
Bristleback going deep against the Fimo. Loco will TP in. Will not get off the stun. Fimo will die, but the nuke damage is there. Now he's going straight onto Edoism. Actually using a regen rune, ballsy there. In fact, the regen rune will actually stay on him throughout the duration.
All Legendism had to do is just slap him in the face and run away. Oh, he doesn't have a level in Curse of Avernus, so...
You don't usually take that on support.
Yeah, you do prioritise a Aphotic Shield and the Miscoil.
Well, LC! Having to use... LC does look very much dead. Ravage will kill him off there. Meanwhile, Queen of Pain trying to blink around, not really working out in her favor, she will die. Ooh. Loco, will he die to Cola Light? Yes, he will, getting whole 500 gold, actually, what, 1,000 gold for Bristleback there. Fimo will be the next one to fall, taking a lot of damage, Bristleback going absolutely ham.
Cola Light is now Cola Heavy with all of that farm he just got, 2k gold. Just, well played indeed.
Just standard Cola. Oh Arkosh, no. Wolverate is there though.
Bit late to the party.
He will not actually do much there, and will Cola Light pursue? He will actually retreat. There's Haxor doing whatever he can. In fact, he's Cola gonna Light. Start going in on Residuans. That's freezing field, but it's too little. Abaddon is there to kill the kill. Where is Abaddon actually? Oh, there he is. Here he comes. No TP's coming in now. Abaddon has to start running. Photic shield is pop. That's unfortunate.
I love the sound of Laguna Blaze. It's 420 Laguna Blaze it now.
That is
420 mana.
That is true. It's a very satisfying sound.
It is. It's like whooshing.
And then when you kill someone with it.
Oh yeah, it's the best feeling in the whole entire world.
Good net worth drafts there. 3,000 for Rhino.
Oh, Fimo's coming in, he's got the Tranquil Boots, the Glimpse is up, what? See that finger?
Not really.
On the top lane.
Oh!
The Glimpse back and the finger hit him.
Zap.
Christ.
I'm guessing the spell was already casted at that point, no point of no return.
Yeah, it was like that long.
Oh, Loco! Nice hex there. Will he get fail though? Edowism meanwhile is. What was that stun? What was that stun line? I've got to ask you that. Loco has to run. Oh, they just missed him. They're going the wrong way.
Loco's only 900.
In fact, CM's like, oh yeah, here I am, and you're going to die because of that. Oh, not. In fact, Fimo's stuck. Oh dear. Ah, fine. Okay. Arkosh actually going in from behind and getting the Queen of Pain.
Well played by him. He's already got the Blink Dagger up, that's really quick, and he's got 1300 gold on top as well as the Arcanes. Arkosh is having a dream start to this game.
Yeah, definitely is. I mean, and you have to say, Haxor is not doing bad for playing a CM. She's only 2-2-4 right now.
Yeah, why not? And it's only got 1100 gold on Haxor as well, so I hope to see a Blink Dagger so we can see some manly plays from the
Bot lane. Residuans are just diving deep right into the cooldown. Warrate will get caught out by the Luna though, thanks to Eclipse. In fact, Eclipse will kill both of them.
I think that they thought that Eclipse is on cooldown. There you go.
Yeah.
Well, that Eclipse is down. Let's get a kill on this Luna quickly. The Luna's quite squishy, but what happened was is they put all of the damage between the Disruptor and the Luna. They should have just focused all on one.
Yep, and here comes Loco. You got a point there. I mean, they were just focusing everything on too many people. Will Loco end up dead here?
Pink.
No, actually, Haxor's dead to help, and he does have ult. It's 60 seconds. In fact, Fail is there, and he has to blink out to save his skin. Ah, there.
Nice. Ooh. 4, 3, 2, 1. Out.
Good job there. Actually, he'll have killed with the Lina. Nice blink back there. Stun onto Cola Light. Haxor is actually looking for him. Bit of focus. No. Nice mobility from Fail here. Just gonna run off.
Yeah, really well played, and you baited that out perfectly. Then we're just looking at Arkosh in the mid lane, gonna get that mid tower down, get some money Wonga.
Going has his blink, and he's gonna use the full effect. Unfortunately, the glimpse is there. Residu and Tatsu wants to get this.
Yeah, the mid tower's in denial raid.
Aww. Shame. Arkosh wanted to just snipe out the tower.
So, 60.
Ooh, fail!
Well, there was 69 last time. Gets. Just, I think she's purchasing KB. What do you think?
MKB. Oh, she's getting a. She's BKB. Yeah, BKB. I thought you said MKB like.
The possess the tomato creep, and that's gonna probably go stack some ancients.
You know, I'm not seeing the late game on Rhino side. They need to get Wolverate farmed, and that hasn't been happening. Oh, Loco, Lina just getting another kill on the Disruptor. Now Loco's being chased down by Cone of Light though. Wolverate's here. Will Loco survive this? Probably not. Wolverate is there to help, but how far can he help? Now Fimo's in. Loco needs to get out of there. Will Loco be able to get out of there? No TP in for 13 seconds. Cooldown is there to zone it out. Cone of Light will end up dead, most likely. In fact, Queen of Pain is dead as well. Loco's running. Enemism is going to die as well. Completely turned around. Brilliant freezing field.
How did Loco live?
You what?
Loco lived, like, through the whole of that.
Just hid.
Yeah, just hid in the corner. They think they took much.
You are lagging again.
I'm lagging again. Am I lagging still?
No, now you're not.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening.
Ooh, Axel Residuans, Axis has to pop Eclipse if he wants to even get a kill, but he's not even going to get out.
Yeah, it was unlucky for him. The bounces were wrong.
Bounces were off the point.
Yeah. I think they're just going to bow down the top lane now.
Oh, no, Wolverate, you're staying in for a bit too long. Cooldown is used once again. Oh, the Ravage is there! And it's gonna get fail the kill. Well, Arkosh is gonna sacrifice himself for this or not. Freeze on to fail, Luna. Lina gets a nice. Cola Light will probably end up dead here. Hex is on him, but no, the Apotic Shield as well. Static Storm was used at the beginning of the fight. Edoism is healing himself back up. Loco is now going on to LC, and LC will end up dead. Edoism's frozen. Cone of Light wants to go in from behind. Edoism will end up dead next. Will Fimo be the next one to die? There's too much stun coming out. Freeze will be there. Oh dear. Cone of Light, wrong decision, and he is dead. Everyone low, but four people dead. That's good.
More gold going the way of Rhino Gaming, and Wolverate is looking stacked right now. Got 3k gold on top of the helm in the Dominator phase boots. I think it's just a BKB, right? Or Jarrah?
Yeah, just start the BKB. Start the BKB, yeah. Especially versus this team.
Tank up against the pure damage of Queen of Pain. He's gone the casual Yasha, probably Sanjin Yasha then.
Sanjin Yasha first, going to the BKB afterwards.
Yeah, that's a great point.
Smokes up from both of them.
Yeah,
was that a baited? Was that a baited TP?
Ooh.
Fimo actually baited a TP there. It's pretty good.
Don't you know I'm loco?
Let's have a look at the net worth graph. It's reaching 10,000 for Rhino. Pretty good. And about 12,000 for Rhino as well on the XP.
Yeah, there's a few more towers to go down yet, so we're not sure if it's non-consensual as of yet.
Yeah, I mean, Rhino hasn't lost... There's only lost one tower. Fail is actually going to be caught out here. Freezing Field used to secure the kill. Let it go.
Can't hold me back anymore.
Yes.
I'm just maybe late. Good.
Maybe later. Maybe same question. Oh, Wolverate! Getting a kill on the Disruptor, but will return kill on the Bristle, who's going to grab himself a Glimmer Cape?
Okay. Glimmer Cape works, I think. Like, they are really far behind, and the Glimmer Cape deserves the life of his teammates.
I mean, it gives him a nice amount of magic reduction as well, yeah.
Yeah, it's probably one of the good best catch-up items in this whole game, I think.
But nowadays, yeah.
Yeah, like a Midas, the Glimmer Cape can really save your teammates' lives and prevent the other team getting a massive gold lead. You know, you can Glimmer and out, so that's always really good. But they have a lot of AoE stun. The the Radiant team, so I'm not sure that they're going to go for the TP out.
Well, we'll see. We'll definitely see. Ooh, Edoism. Oh, just missing, managing to blink out of that scream of pain right there. She has her ult, by the way, which means BKBs will not be worth anything anymore.
Scepter on the Queen of Pain as well.
I mean, it definitely will be worth something, but not as much as they used to be. Luna, that BKB will not save you from the 570 pure damage, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
No, hang on. Well, that's a lot more than I expected. It's actually 950. Okay, then. Yeah. Rosita and Zatsi is very much dead. In fact, LC's just gonna eat it.
Next level, 950 damage from. Wow, Luna gets one-shotted. I think. Luna's gonna die over and over again to this. Lina.
Most of these, anyone she really targets who's only taken like a scratch will end up instantly dead. Fails,
like, for example, Queen of Pain only has 1400 HP.
Same with the Bristleback, actually.
Yeah, and it's pure damage, so it doesn't really give a crap about the Bristleback.
Oh, there's Fail, and looks like it wants to do his entire combo, but it doesn't matter because Arkosh is there. And Edoism will start healing up thanks to the static field, but you know what? It doesn't matter because Wolverine is there on the back line. Luna's already dead. Luna's actually going to respawn now. And that was... I overhyped that one, unfortunately.
They committed two ultimates and got absolutely nothing from it.
Yeah. Oh, Fimo. Edoism's caught out. He's hexed. He should be very much dead. Oh, Freezing Field is used to secure it. These freezing fields have been very aggressive, as well as Loka getting a kill on the Disruptor. Luna decides to eclipse, but they're going to eat all the damage. Loka actually dies. Oh, Fail. Wolverate, nice mechanism. Nice mechanism pop there. Fail will probably end up very dead. No, he's able to get out. Rosita runs out. Will he be the next one to target? Who's going to die next is the question.
Penis.
I don't see it, unfortunately. Ah, Jairo got the kill screen of pain. Nice! Yeah. Nice killing the gyro. So that's three and a buyback. Three dead and buyback for one.
Oh, it's a very low. Oh, Luna. Nah, he blinks out. He should have bumped in. He has Finger of Death up and it's level 11.
Axor? No.
Nah, his freezing field's on cooldown. He's not going to go against five of them. Not yet. When it's up, though, it'll go 1v5. Crits up Mandan. Let's do this.
Yes, let's go carry Maiden.
Mid Maiden, I went Mjolnir, Illus, sorted.
Cool, that's just standard mid Maiden, of course.
Oh, yeah, of course. You can get a Blink Dagger in there as well if you want to.
If you absolutely
They reduced
want
the cooldown of Freezing Field, it's 90 seconds now.
I believe they did.
Yeah, that's a big buff that Crystal Maiden needed.
You know what I'm seeing? Tidehunter's about to get Guardian Greaves, which is gonna be so scary. Oh, Haxor's caught out! They're not going to use static field for this though. LC will be caught out. Axel's going to just walk out of that static field. Use too late. Freezing field's in and it's going to be a full duration channel. Most likely no. Actually, Axel's dying to the Luna. Oh no. No one died there other than LC, who didn't even die to Axel. Now two people are dead. Can they do more? Screw wave. Sonic Wave is out. Ooh, nice ult there. Killing the Luna. Fail wants to get a kill here. Fail really wants it, but it might backfire on her. Where is Wolverate? Wolverate is actually just going to start pushing top. Meanwhile, Cola, Light, and Abaddon both fall. And this is pretty much it. Fail's running. Fail has to run. He's going to use Blink, but Blink, Arkosh Blink in, and so does Loco. Will they be able to get the kill? Yes, they will.
Triple kill. And Loco.
You know, in that entire engagement, Arkosh was just farming up top the entire time.
Yeah, and Wolverate's just gonna down this tower right now, I think.
Yeah, no, that's what I meant. Wolverate, sorry. Anyway. He's, in fact, almost... He's buying an Aghanim's?
Wait, who?
Wolverate.
We get to see it!
We get to see the global cooldowns, eh?
Yeah, just do some Dota 2 headshot, you know. Cue the music. And when they're running back to base on like 5 health, and then you just get that cooldown in. Though, Aghanim Scepter, why is it not so popular on the Gyrocopter?
I think it's because it's just an underwhelming upgrade, really.
Yeah, that's a good point. Increases the damage of the second missile, though.
I mean, yeah, but it's like, he's a carry. He needs carry items. It's one, by the second, by the time you've got 4,200 gold spent on an item which increases your ult, which is a purely magical entity. It does pay spell immunity. I think only the slow pays a spell immunity. I'm not sure, though.
Yeah, the slow does. I think it could be really effective, like, if you're committed to farm all, so you just use your cooldown to split push.
Could also use the cooldown to split push, as base defense also makes it really good. You can split push and use the cooldown to save the base defense.
Yeah, it's probably a good late game item on Gyrocopter, like you just put it in your inventory or your stash.
Yeah,
just pull that out when you need it. Your courier can have your own personal acceptor, just follow you around.
Just get your own personal courier.
Yeah, you do what Eternal Envy does.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Luna's found.
Ooh, Fimo! But you know what? He has Hex. Oh, but they have Glimpse. And that's a dead Fimo. What a good stun, though. Is this going to be an initiation? In fact, Arkosh is Glimmer caping up. There's an initiation! Axel's still taking a lot of damage, though. There's the wave, Sonic Wave. And it looks like this might actually be a turnaround for the team of the Dire. Wolverate's there. Cooldown is used. In fact, oh, Cola Light not taking any damage from that. Glimmer keeps saving him, in fact, but he will not die to the insane damage that Gyro has. Just waiting for Edison to be off cooldown. There we go. Off he goes. He's dead as well. 3-2 now.
There we go. Indeed. And there's more gold going the way of Wolverate, so he's got 1,000 gold plus a...
Another point booster? He's going Scuddy.
Scuddy.
No, wait, you get an alternate orb first for that.
The Dire couldn't hang on. Maybe it's altering core.
He's going the full alt build.
Huh. He could
actually,
do that.
Actually, you know, you do realise that, yeah, I think if you use Flak Cannon with the Octarine Core, it also leeches.
It does.
Where was that alt used? Oh, there, okay.
Oh, in the mid there.
Who is caught out? Fimo is, but just gonna stun and walk. No, he's gonna die. In fact, Luna though, Loco is just gonna kill off, actually not gonna kill off Kool-Aid. Kool-Aid of Light. A Glimmer Cape doing some work. In fact, Loco has a Bloodstone though.
Yeah.
Radiant's top tower's hurt. Let's see what happens later on into this game, because Luna's actually starting to get some farm up now by taking some creep camps. Yeah, Luna's actually getting quite substantial.
She only has a Yasha though as a real true damage item. Arkosh is dominating, getting a kill on the Queen of Pain. Arkosh will be glimpsed back, but I probably just don't want him to do anything else because he's been pretty good. Edoism will die here though. Fall
yes,
down onto those two.
On Loco.
Loco's just like, I'm gonna ult someone. I wanna ult someone, but LC is out of vision. She could have blinked up there, but I don't think that would have been the best of choices. What is Wolverine gonna get? Wait, what?
What? What's he. But he's gone for the booty travel and he has the phase boots as well. I'm quite.
Wolverine's going some weird build here. He's
yeah,
going.
Maybe just...
He's going the got to go fast build.
5-2-2 move speed plus face boots.
Just says I'm gonna. Anytime you guys come attack me, I'm gonna roam. Like, they're gonna take an easy rush here. Rhino is.
Yep, and I think that. Do you know you Loco? Do you know I'm Loco? Probably pick up.
Yes, he will, and they instantly smoke up. Let's see, Wolverine.
Yeah, Wolverine's gonna try and bait something out. Oh, Hacksaw goes in.
That's a dead Cola Light, most likely. Ah, he's got the Glimmer Cape up though. Edoism is on his ult, so you can't kill him now. That's a good ult from Lina, but is it good? Yep, it's good. Wolverine will get the last hit.
I don't think the Ravage was necessary, though.
Not really, no. In fact, they could have kept the Ravage for now, where they're pushing into the base. The penis has been activated, and here's a static field. That's a good static field. Eclipse not hitting the right targets, though. Loco, meanwhile, going crazy on the back line. In fact, Eclipse does nothing. It's only a level. It's level 3, but it's not doing anything. Good freezing field, getting 2, getting 3. That's a team wipe. And Luna buys back, but what can she do against this?
I'm just going to run top lane and get another set of racks.
That's the one set of racks down. Rhino will probably take this game. Let's look at the net worth one last time. 25,000 up to 30,000. It's a lot, and finally, Residuum and Zuts will end up as the final casualty of this engagement.
I think this GG, they're just going to smash down the towers.
GG, well played, yep. As I said, she will remain final casualty of this game. And Rhino will move on to play against Wasted Talent.
Yeah, and just final later, right? Later today, the final.
Yeah, like, either at 6 or in a few minutes. Until then, we shall see ya.
See you later, thanks for watching.
My comrades.